morning.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is David Pofelt. I'm the managing director of Massive Entertainment, a pretty good studio here in Malmo. And it is my great pleasure today to co-host this next hour with an industry legend, the creator of Ico, Shadow of the Colossus, and Last Guardian, Mr. Fumito Ueda. So today we will have a kind of a small fireside chat. We will use the help of Hiromi, who will translate for us. So we'll try to keep up the pace and cover everything from youth to the future.
Hey.
So Ueda-san, let's start at the beginning and then work ourselves gradually towards the future. So first of all, how long have you been in the game industry?
僕がもう25歳の時に、ゲーム業界に初めて入ったんですけど、25歳っていうのは日本で言うとそれほど早くない年なんですけど、それから数えると、22年ですかね。
I've joined the industry at the age of 25. That was not too young in Japan, joining the new industry. So since then, it has been 22 years now.
Okay, and for me, I've been in the industry around 20 years as well, so...
Like the same amount of period.
Yeah. So maybe we can call ourselves veterans soon. Maybe we can call ourselves veterans in the end. So before the gaming industry, what did you do?
ですね、僕の場合はですね、大学でモダンアートの方を勉強してまして、そのモダンアートの表現自体、ファインアートだったんですけど、アートにその自分の限界を感じたっていうのと、自分が表現しているものが何か矛盾を感じたんですね。というのは、僕はあんまり、その、アートに対してあんまり興味がなかったっていうとちょっと誤解があるんですけど、アートよりもエンターテイメントの方が実は好きなタイプの人間で、で、自分が表現している、その学生時代に表現しているアートの表現と、自分が普段こう家で帰って映画だったりゲームをしてるっていうところと矛盾を感じて、そこをもっと素直に自分がやりたいことをやるべきなんじゃないかと思って、最初にそのアミーガってコンピューターを買って、そこからですかね、ゲームの世界に入ろうと思ったのは。
So I majored the art, modern art at school, and trying to make something so-called fine art. But So I realized that today it's a little bit contradiction as an art majored person, but realized that I'm not so much interested in art, rather interested in entertainment. So much more draw into the movies or other forms of entertainment. Then I took a distance from the modern art world and bought an Amiga, a computer called Amiga.And started to make something. So that's the, I think, beginning.
All right. So do you, you can paint properly?
そうですね。僕が大学時代に専攻してた、ペインティングというか絵画は抽象絵画だったんですね。具象絵画ではなくて。
I majored in abstract painting.
Okay.
なので今僕がこうゲームを作る上で描いてる絵の技術っていうのは大学時代というよりはその高校それ以前の学校で学んだその技術で絵を描いてる。
So I draw now to make my own games, but that technique I didn't get it at university, rather like high school before that art education. So I used the same one from that time.
It's interesting. Then apparently both of us come from art school.
そうですね。そのあたりってどうなんですか。こちらの美術学校からそのゲームインダストリーにそのままこう入る人たちってのは多いんですか。
Let me ask about the, those art schools in Sweden or Scandinavia. Are there many people joining the gaming industry directly from art school?
I don't think so, to be honest.
そうですね。特に僕らの時代だとまだコンピューターが発達してなかったので、僕も大学を卒業して初めてコンピューターに触れたので。
So when I was a university student, there aren't so many computers available. So the first time I used a computer, it was after my graduation from the school.
I remember when I came to my art school, there was one computer for 400 students.And they say it's only for advanced students, so you couldn't use it until the fourth year.
そうですね。いや、でも同じような感じでした。
It's kind of the same situation in Japan at that time too.
Yeah. I've actually never met somebody with the same degree as me. I have a master's degree in fine arts.But I haven't met anybody with that same degree in the game industry ever, so.
はい。ああ、そうですね。
Until now, of course.
そうですね。
So, let's talk about the first job in the game industry. How did you, Eda-san, how did you get your first job in the gaming industry, and what was it?
はい。うん、ですね、もともとそのアミーガっていうコンピューターを買って、独学で、そのコンピューターを使おうとして、で、その中で 3D の CG と出会って、で、もともとその 3D の CG をやりたいと思ってコンピューター買ったわけじゃないんですけど、まあ、アニメーションが好きだったってことと、それまで学んできたアートっていうのが、そこでうまく融合して、これが、自分は得意なんじゃないかなっていうふうに、もうその時は勘違いしたのか思って、で、それで作った映像作品を最初に SCE、ソニーの前の会社に送って採用されたのが最初です。
So I talked about I bought Amiga computer and in that package it was included the CG animation tool. So then it was not my first intention to make animation, but since that there was a tool, so I started to create the animation film. And soon I realized that I may be very good at this. And created a short film and sent to the, it's not to Sony, but to the company I worked before Sony, to the that company. So that is the, my start.At the gaming industry.
Do you often feel that you're very good at things, or was that a rare moment?
その時のタイトル。そうですね。タイトル自体は、CG アニメーターだったので、そのゲームデザインであったり、プロダクト全体のコントロールってところまでは、僕はタッチしてないんですけど、自分が担当したその CG アニメーションの部分に関して言うと、まあ、限られた時間の中で精一杯やって、本当にその限られた時間の中で、たくさんの仕事をこなすっていうことに関して言うと、そこで学んだことが、その後に、そのイコやワンダを作った時の、その糧になってるなっていうふうに、今は感じますね。
So、at that company, I didn't see over whole title, rather worked as a CG animator. But in the that assignment, and the time was very limited too.But in that time limitation and those very high speed of the development phase, I think I made it quite a good one.
So let's talk about then the move to Sony and the origins of Ico, because it seems like a very bold move for Sony to dare to do that. And how did that happen?
うん、そうですね。うん、その最初に入ったスタジオで、1年半ぐらいいたんですけど、そうですね。CG アニメーターとして僕はやってたんですけど、まあ、その中でこう、ふつふつと、うん、やっぱり自分の作品を作りたい。自分の作品がこれだって自信を持てる作品を作りたいっていう気持ちが芽生えてきて、で、その1年半ぐらいしかいなかったその会社で、まあ、ある程度その貯蓄というんですかね、貯金もできたので、自分の作品を作るために辞めますっていうことで、退社したんです。 で、
So I worked at that first studio for 1.5 years. And so working as a CG animator. But then I got those feeling like I want to create my own work, my own title. Then I started to save money and say to the studio that I'm going to quit because I want to create my own.
で、その時にもう考えてたのがそのイコっていうタイトル で、それはまだゲームなのか映画なのか何かわからないんですけど、まあ、プログラマーもいなかったですし、僕一人とあともう一人、一緒にその CG を作れる人間がいたんで、その二人でイコというタイトルで何かそういう、まあ、もう最初からあのイメージはあったんですけど、背の高い女の子と少年が手をつないで城から脱出するっていう映画かゲームかわからないんだけど、それのパイロットムービーを作ろうっていうところからスタートして、で作り始めたんですけど、まあそのうち、生活費というかね、あのその貯金も食いつぶしてしまって、働かないといけないなってところで、たまたまその時に SC が、CG のアニメーターを募集してたんで、でそこで応募したんですね。でフルタイムで働くのはさすがに自分の作品が作りたいので無理で、週に何回かだったら来れますって話をして、でなぜ来れないのかっていうふうに聞かれて、でいやそれは自分の作品を作りたいからだっていうふうに言ったら、じゃあうちでやればいいんじゃないっていうふうにお声掛けいただいて、そこから以降その SC の中で作ってる。
So at that time I quit that studio, I already had the idea of Ico.The name of the title too, and the visual image that the tall girl pulled by a boy, just holding a hand. But I was not sure that would be a movie or a game. But what I want to create, I already got in my head. And so I started to work by myself, but soon another CG graphic artist started to create.And doing by my own. Then my savings money is going out, so I needed to start to work. Then I found the announcement of the Sony Computer Entertainment at that time, looking for a CG artist. So I applied for that, but I had one condition for Sony that I cannot work full time because I need the time.For myself too. Then Sony asked, "What are you doing for your own time?" Eh? Then I started to talk about the Ico project. Sony understood how brilliant idea, and why don't you do that your project at Sony? So wow. That's the beginning.
It's a very smart move by Sony.
そうですね。今思うとそうだと思います。
And
I think so too.
And did you believe at the time that Ico would be a very big commercial success, or did you think of it as a niche title?
ですね。そうですね。あの僕のその当時の希望とすれば、何もかもが初めてだったので、とにかくとんがったものを作らないと誰からも注目されないんじゃないかっていうふうに意識はしてました。ただ、それほどたくさん売れるっていうふうには考えてなくて、とりあえず初めての作品なので、誰かに刺さればいい、誰かの気持ちに届けばいいっていうようなスタンスで作ってましたね。
So for me, it was a very first time with everything.So I'm not aiming anything, but important I thought is it must be edgy, must be standing out from the other crowd, must be attract people's attention to it. Mm. And for the commercial side, maybe not selling, but that was not important. Most important thing is to standing out.
So pretty cool. So.I forgot to say before that we've also integrated a bunch of questions from the community before we prepared this presentation. So we're going to throw in a couple of odd questions here. And here's one that I like. If you could have any job in the world except the one you have now, what would it be?
Ah, そうですね。もともとは、学生時代にアートもやってましたし、映画も自分たちで撮ってたんで、映画の仕事につければいいなって漠然とは考えてましたけど、今僕自身がこう振り返って思うのは、そのアートだったり、映画だったり、あとコミックだったり、あともっと言うと、そのコンピューターに対する、そのオタク的なその、なんていうんですかね、好奇心だったりっていうものが、すべてうまく融合できてるのは、今のビデオゲームを作るところに、全部が無理なく、無駄なく生かされてるってことを考えると、まあ、天職かなというふうに考えてますね。
So, I was majoring in art, as I told. And also, I was filming the movie with a friend, student time. But the game, so interested in those areas too. But the other interests as a node, like a comics and the movies and the art, but game combines, I mean, you can combine everything in game. All the different types of interest. Mm. So I cannot think of any other job than what I'm doing now.
Well, thank God.
そのあたりってデビッドさんなんかあるんですかね
How about you, David?
I think I would like to be a writer. Because believe it or not, I find it quite stressful with a lot of people. And I would like to have a job where I was alone.
Oh, 一人です。
You know what I'm talking about.
そうですね。
Okay, so let's talk a little bit about inspirations and things that inspire you as a creator. So do you listen a lot to music?
そうですね。仕事をするときは、音楽を聴きます。というのは、僕が今表現しているものっていうのはファンタジー、リアルファンタジーの世界。というのは、現実の世界には存在しない世界ですよね。で、僕はどちらかというと、もともとファンタジーが大好きで、ファンタジーを表現しているっていうタイプの人間ではなくて、ある程度そのファンタジーの世界にダイブして、そこの住人にならないと、その世界を想像できないタイプなんですよ。なので、聞く音楽も、まあ、ファンタジー色が強い音楽をヘッドホンで聞いて、その世界にダイブして、どんなことが起こるんだろう。こういうことが起これば、お客さんに対して説得力を感じてもらえるんじゃないかっていうふうに、自分をこう持ち上げないと、乗せないとなかなかそういう世界って表現できないんで、聞く音楽っていうのは大体そうなりますね。映画のサントラとか。
I listen a lot while I'm working. What I'm creating is a fantasy world.And it's a creation of that. But personally, I'm not very interested in fantasy or very fond of that. But what I need to do is I need to dive into the world I want to create and feel that world and just need to be inside that world. Then music helps me.So what I listen to, it can be those movie soundtrack tunes, this type of, so it makes me feel like I'm in a fantasy world. So in that sense, I listen a lot to go into the world I'm trying to make. In.
So it's the epic quality of the music that triggers the fantasy.
そうですね。どちらかというと僕は現実主義者だと思うので、ふとしたことで自分がこう創作しているファンタジーの世界、ありもない世界っていうのは存在しないんじゃないかっていうふうに疑心暗鬼になることが多いんですね。で、それをさせないために、そういう、まあ音楽だけじゃないですけど、そういうファンタジー色の強いものだったり、音楽を聴いたり、その本を読んだり、することで、あ、こういう世界が存在しててもおかしくないんだなっていうふうに、自分をやっぱりこう、鼓舞するというか、しないとなかなかこう、その世界のイマジネーションが自分の中で広げられないってタイプなんですよね。
As a person, I'm pretty much practical. It's not the fantasy type. And, but I really need to believe that, that world I'm creating exists there. So I need to make myself believe by the, getting an inspiration by music or books that, that handles those fantasy world.
多分皆さんは僕をこうファンタジーの世界で生きてる人だと思われてるっていうのはわかるんですけど、実際はそうではない。そのズレはちょっと感じますね。
A lot of people believe I'm such a fantasy person of a fantasy and living in that fantasy world all the time. But I feel I understand that there is a huge gap from people's perception of myself and me as a person.
Okay, we'll come back to asking some questions about you as a person later on. But when we talk about the music, do you play? Do you, are you in headphones or do you play it bombastically in the entire studio?
Headphone, ですね。
With a headphone.
Headphones. Okay. Cool.
音楽を聴きながら仕事したりするんですか?
Do you listen to music while you are working?
Yes, I do. But a little bit in the same way. I use music to trigger.Thought. So depending on what I need to do, I will choose something really mellow or death metal. So, I also know, Ueda-san, that you watch a lot of movies. What kind of movies? What's your favorite movie?
ですね、特定のタイトルを選ぶのはたくさん好きな映画があるんで難しいんですけど、僕が好きな映画の、傾向があるとすれば、その大衆に対してちゃんと、評価されてる、ちゃんと届いてる、あまりこう映画の知識がない人たちからも評価されてるし、映画の批評家からも評価されてるし、その両方を何ですかね、取り込めてる作品がやっぱり素晴らしいなっていうふうに思うので、僕が何かこうゲームであったり表現しようとするときは、特に同じように、分け隔てなく、知識がなかったとしても楽しめるし、知識があるとより楽しめるってものを作りたいなと思うので、そういう映画が好きですね。
So there are so many movies I like, so it's very, very difficult to pick just titles.But there is a movie, like a tendency I have, with kind of movies which I like is like appeals to the broad audience, broad public. But at the same time, it also getting a great reviews of the critics. So it covers both areas. You can enjoy as a person who doesn't have any knowledge or deep understanding of it to...to watch it, those usual people appreciate that movie, but also the people, those music lovers or critics also love that movie. That kind of a movie, I like them too.
Yeah, I fully agree. I think that the use of broad entertainment as a tool to reach a big audience is a very fine.Tool, in fact. It's easy to be a snob about it, but I fully agree with that. I'm going to start talking about game design, but I have one question here from the community as well. If you could step into one of the worlds that you created for Ico, Shadow, or The Last Guardian, which one would it be? Which is your favorite world?
はい。ああ、なるほど。難しい質問ですね。
It's a very difficult question.
ただ、強いて言うならラストガーディアンですかね。
So, I really need to choose the last
one. No, you don't have to choose. But why is it difficult? Is it because it's like your babies, or is it because they are very different, or why is it difficult to choose?
なぜラストガーディアンを選んだかっていう理由にもあるんですけど、イコもシャドウもとてもその主人公として入った場合に太刀打ちできない敵がたくさんいる。だけどラストガーディアンの場合はそれを守ってくれるというか対峙してくれる、まあ、トリコが近くにいる分、安心かなっていうところで選びました。
I can talk about the reason why I choose the last guardian. If you go into the Ico or the Shadow, there are enemies you need to fight against. But in the last guardian, you have Toriko who can protect me, so I feel safe in that.
Okay. We talked a little bit about when you started working on Ico, but let's look more at the actual art of making games. So for you, how do you start with a project? Where does it begin? Does it begin with an image or a person or a location? How does it begin in your studio?
そうですね。それぞれこれまで作ってきたイコだったりシャドウだったりラストガーディアンというのは、それぞれ違うんですけど、基本的にはアートもテクノロジーも、まあ、それこそロゴのデザインから、まあ、同時に積み上げていくスタイルではあるんですけど、どれか一つが突出してっていうのはあまりなくて、ただその中でもイコの場合はその先も言いましたけど、背の高い女の子と男の子が手をつないでいるっていうビジュアルが、絵になる、フックになるっていうところからスタートして、でそこから、手をつなぐっていうゲームメカニックを思いついてっていうような流れです。でその次の、シャドウに関して言うと、それとは少し逆で、ビジュアルよりも先にしがみつくっていうゲームルールだったりゲームメカニックを思いついて、その後にその馬に乗った広大な場所を走るっていうのはその後から来てるので、そうですね。その都度バラバラです。トリコはまた少しイコに戻って、大きなこう、生き物にしがみついて、狭い足場の塔の上に、窮屈そうに乗っているその巨大な生き物に自分がしがみついているという状況が、自分の中でそのワクワクしたというか、そういう世界に行ってみたいなというふうに感じて、スタートしましたね。
So it's different for each titles, actually.But generally, I can say that I do everything at the same time. You said like a visuals, stories, and those game mechanics. Try to proceed everything at the same time. But I can talk about a little bit more about the Ico. For the case of Ico, I had a visual, as I told you at the beginning of this conversation, that those tall girl and they.A boy is holding a girl's hand. That visual is a starting point. Then the visual is a starting point. Then those mechanics like holding a hand came to the next. Then to the other point. For the case of a shadow, it's a little bit started on the mechanic. It is interesting to have you are just.Crumbling with a huge colossus, I can make something from this one. Then those idea of riding a horse in the open world came after. So that is for the case of Shadow. And for Toriko, I had the visual image of Toriko is just sitting on the top of very, very,high but very narrow place on the top, and there is a boy just hanging on that Toriko. That visual image is a starting point for the last guy.
At that point, do you understand the story yourself?
Story も。ですね、大体のプロットと呼ばれるものは決めてましたね。あと、ぼんやりとしたエンディングは考えてました。例えば、イコの場合で言うと、長く連れ添ったというか、一緒に冒険した女の子が、まあ、あるきっかけで記憶を失って、その男の子のことを覚えてるんだろうか、どうだろうか、みたいなエンディングは考えてました。 ただそれは最終的には変わったんですけど、なので、プロットはあるんだけど、あまりそれを重要視せずに、ゲームルールだったり、その時のチームのリソースだったり、ハードウェアの制限だったりで、その都度変えていって、その中で最適なストーリーだったり、エンディングっていうのを作るようにしてますね。
I had just a rough idea of the whole plot of the title, and some sort of idea of the ending scene also.Like for Ico, the ending or story is like a boy and a girl, they knew each other, but at some point she lost her memories. So at the end of the game, does she remember this boy before her? But that was not the actual ending. So but that was the ending image I had at the beginning of the production. So rough plot or rough ending would change during the creation development phase due to the technical limitations, due to the resource management, so need to prioritize some other things.
So I love these games, and when I play them, I don't try very hard to understand the story.I take it in as poetry, in fact, as a more of an emotional experience. But then it struck me yesterday when we spoke that maybe for you the story is very clear and you want people to understand. Or is it intentionally mysterious?
Right.そうですね。明確な答えっていうのは自分の中では、あまり重要視はしてなくて、日本の表現で俳句だったり短歌だったり、その短い文節で、それを読んだ人にいろいろイマジネーションを広げてもらうっていう表現があるんですけど、僕はそういう表現が好きで、好きだし、ビデオゲームで何かを表現するっていう、物語を表現するっていうところでも、そういう表現が合ってるんじゃないかなっていうふうに考えていて、なので、今みたいな、あまりこう全てを明かすことなく、表現してるっていう、まあ、スタイルをとってるんじゃないかなと思います。ただ、それがビデオゲームで物語を表現する上で、これしかないのかって言われたらそうではなくて、多分今後ビデオゲームの開発がもっともっと成熟していくと、もっと新しい何かの物語表現、もっとやりやすい物語表現っていうのが出てくるんじゃないかなっていうふうに期待もしています。
So for me, it's not important to tell the detailed story. And in Japan, there is a poet expression called a haiku or a tanka.So you just, you don't explain in a detail. You just put some things and let those receivers to understand or get the imagination from what you presented. So, and that kind of you just leave the receivers to make their own stories or their, from their imagination is also, I think it's a very good expression style for the gaming at this moment. In the future, somebody may discover another way to do the narrative or tell the story in the gaming, but at this moment, I think that's a good way to tell the story in game.
Well, it certainly works for me.Because in your games, there are a lot of question marks. But because there are question marks, they live with me longer. It makes me think about them in a different way. And I really like that.
そうですね。それは自分でも意識していることで、まあ、よく映画なんかで、まあ、特定のタイトルを出すわけにはいかないんですけど、あまりにもまとまりすぎるっていうんですかね。整合性が取りすぎて、見たお客さんの頭に何も残らない ていうものよりは少し何かこうずれがあったりして、それがずっと頭に引っかかるっていうのが、その作品をこう長く思いとどめてもらう手法なんじゃないかなとすら思ってますね。
It's good to hear because I intentionally, really intentionally do that. And also for the movies,there is some movie, I don't pick up any titles, but there are some movie, just the story is so complete. There is anything, any end you can guess, or it's already done and completed. That type of movies doesn't give us any long lasting impression.
This is
because of the, there are some question marks in your head, you really get, yeah.
It's a really powerful tool narratively. Okay, so now we have the illustration, we have the beginning of the story and the beginning of the mechanics. So your studio is in production. So what is it like in your studio? Is it a factory, or is it an organic chaos? Or is it very quiet? What is the production situation like?
そうですね。これまで以降、ワンダトリコと作ってきた中では、もうみんな静かに粛々と作ってるっていう印象ですね、僕から見ると。
For last three titles, from my point of view, when I see them, it's they just keep working on, keep working on it quietly, just go proceed.
It's like
concentrated and focus on the what they need to do.
欧米のスタイル、まあこのスカンジナビアのスタイルだとどうなんですかね。みんなこう音楽かけたりしながらやってるんですかね。
How about the your style over here in the Scandinavia? It's very noisy, or music is in a loud volume, or
actually, games development in progress is much more boring than many people think. It's just a bunch of people with headphones working extremely focused, and a million meetings. So that's really what it's like.
It sounds like the same situation.
Yes, and I believe it's because all of the action is happening in the minds and in the relationship to the computer. So you don't exist so much in the real world at that time. So I forgot to ask you yesterday, are you like a crazy dictator in your studio? You run around and tell everybody what to do? Or are you very open-minded and people can come with ideas? How is the situation? If it's not unpolite to ask, sorry.
よく言われるのは、そのさっきの、言葉足らずな表現というか、その全てに設定が事細かに決まってて、で、これを表現してくださいっていうようなスタイルではないので、作る側としてはどうしてもそのディティールが知りたいっていうふうに、よく怒られます。知りたいんだけど、いや、それは、幅を持って作ってほしいっていうこともあるって、なかなかこれですとは伝えないかったりするので、それでよく怒られますね。
We talked about a movie which doesn't tell everything. His direction style is the same. He just give the direction like, yeah, something like this. Didn't give the details, the detailed points. So the people came back to him. We are kind of angry, like, why can't you explain more what I need to do with this?
Interesting method. And during games development, what do you enjoy the most, and what do you find the most frustrating with making games?
制作中にですよね。制作中に一番楽しいのはやはり、その、イマジネーションを広げてる時です。そういうステータスの時ですね。こんなゲーム作りたい、あんなゲーム作りたいっていうのを研究開発したり、いろんなテストをしたりしてる時が一番楽しくて、 まあ、それはつまりは、次はこうしたい、こうしたいっていうのがどんどん出てきているタイミングですね。で、一番辛いのは、そのこうしたいっていうのが出せなくなるタイミング。うん、あと、基本的には会議とかはあんまり好きじゃないですかね。
I enjoy most when we are just giving up, giving out the ideas. We want to do this and that and trying to make a prototype or just doing some research in that area. We can do this and do that. That phase is really exciting and interesting. And the most stressful or the point I want to get rid of is like I cannot give more ideas.Because I know that I cannot do it. It's not that point. And I also hate, yeah, not so very, like, doesn't like so much meetings.
No. And I think the real mastery of game design is understanding that the phases need very different things. And as a leader, you need to change the studio depending on the phase you're in.And this is sometimes quite hard to understand for junior people, that in the beginning everything is possible, but at the end it's only about closing, in fact, and it's a very different mindset.
そうですね。そうですね。デビッドさんにとってはその開発中に楽しいこと、あと辛い時っていうのはどう違いますかね。
Can I give back the same question to you, David?
Actually, what I enjoy the most is seeing some people reaching a breakthrough as creators when they suddenly go to the next plateau, and you can see.That they have leveled up, and it's amazing for them, but it's also amazing for the project. And those moments I like the most. Sorry?
You don't like the moment you like the least?
No, I enjoy seeing that success in other people, that somehow we created an environment where they were able to reach a new level.
When do you get feel stressed?
The most frustrating, I guess it's the same. Mm-hmm. You run out of time, you need to close, you need to cut a lot of features. It's super frustrating. Mm-hmm. And, but it's necessary, and I think as a good chef, you have to master that phase as well. You cannot be angry at the phase, because the phase has a purpose.
なるほど。
But it's true that almost all game projects starts with amazing dreams. And I remember the first time we pitched The Division to Paris.And it was a great meeting. Everybody was extremely excited. And then the senior guy in Paris, he said, yeah, it's always great in the beginning. And we're like, what do you mean? One thing I also meant to ask is, in Shadow of the Colossus, you opened up the world, and it became a bit more open to the player to choose where to go and in what order to play the levels. But in your next game, you went back to almost perfectly executed linear story. So what are your thoughts about open world versus linear?
Hey.はい、そうですね。ワンダと巨像がオープンワールドかどうかっていうのはわからないですけど、あの当時まだそれほどオープンワールドっていう言葉が、出てきてなかったってこともあって、なぜ ああいうゲームにしたかというと、イコがものすごく閉鎖空間の、実質はそんなに広くないんです、お城も。狭い空間の中で冒険をするというゲームに、開発に4年間かかったんで、そこからのストレスで、次はもっとこう広大な世界を冒険するゲームを作りたいっていうところからスタートして、で、ワンダと巨像は完成させました。
Talking about the shadow,、I don't know if I call that open world, but, and、I don't think there is a world existed at that time, but、that、world, open world,、I created because、Ico was、it as a venture game, but in such a tiny、space.And I spent 4 years in that closed space. Just I wanted to go out to the open space and just go around it.
And do you already know for your next project if it will be more open or if it will be very narratively driven?
まだそこまで具体的にはお話はできないんですけど、イコが閉鎖空間のゲームで、シャドウが広大な世界を冒険するっていうゲーム で、トリコはまたそこからの反省点として、開発期間を短くするであるとか、その当時こう長くこう移動するゲームの世界を移動するってことに、自分がプレイヤーとしても少し疑問に思ってた部分もあって、でもう少しこう濃密な時間を体験させるものの方がいいんじゃないかなってことで、トリコはまた、オープンワールドではなくて、一本道のゲームに戻したっていうのがあるんですけど、またそこにも少しストレスを感じているので、次はまたその反動でシャドウみたいなものにチャレンジしてもいいかななんてのをぼんやり考えてますね。
So I cannot talk about the details, but Ico, so Shadow came out from the experience with Ico. So closed world, open world. Then completed the Shadow, there is a moment I wondered you don't need to go around such an open world. Maybe I go back to those closed space, but spend a more intimate time with something.In that space.、Mm. So that is the starting point for The Last Guardian. And、now I'm completed The Last Guardian, then maybe,、and spent so many years in that game too, maybe、I may go back to the shadow type of、environment.
欧米ではやっぱりオープンワールドのゲームは今後も主流になるっていうふうにデビットさんは感じていますか？
Do you think、it's a major trend here in the Western、countries, like open world is a way to go?
Yes, I think that all of the major publishers, if we're talking AAA games,、are going more and more towards open worlds and creating these giant, very rich playgrounds.And that's great. We're doing a lot of that.、but I do believe that there is a very powerful opportunity in the linear games. And in fact, some of the games that have had the biggest impact、on at me, at least, are、quite linear games, like Last of Us or Ico.、But this brings me to another question. What、do you play games by other developers, or are you completely in your own universe?
Yeah, 自分のゲームはあまりやらないタイプです。完成した後は、見ると、ここをああしたらよかったなとか、こここうしたいみたいなのが出てきても、それを実現できないストレスの方が高いので見ないんですけど、できるだけ発売されて、特に評価されてる、売れてたり評価されてるタイトルは、一応くまなくチェックしてますね。
I don't play my own games.Because、I see only the things I want to change and、I regret maybe I can make it better. So I don't go into my games. So almost never played. But games which are popular and games which a lot of people talk about, I check them out, all of them.
Okay. And do you have a favorite game?
この質問もよく聞かれるんですけど、僕が、ゲーム業界に入ろうと思ったきっかけっていうのもあるんですけど、フランスのゲーム作家のエリック・シャイっていう人のアナザーワールドですかね。それは本当にモニターの中にすごく生々しくリアルに動くキャラクターがいて、本当に僕はその当時の僕はそのモニターの向こう側に世界がこう続いていて、そこの世界を垣間見てるっていう風な感覚を受けて、こういうゲームだったら僕も作ってみたいと思ったきっかけでもあったので、強いて一本って言われるとそれを挙げることが多いですね。
I got this question quite often, and I think I spoke about it at other occasions too. But if I need to choose just one, I choose Eric Schei's Another World. And that is a game from many, many years, those French game creators. And I saw there is a character in those video monitor that felt like it's living inside.And there is another world exists in the TV monitor. So, and I really wanted to create the world exist by myself too. So if I need to choose one game from all the game, I choose that one.
David さんは何かそういうきっかけになったゲームはあるんですか?
How about you, David? What made you come into the gaming world?
ゲームというのは素晴らしいの世界で働きたいっていう。
And yeah, that made you decide you want to work in the gaming industry. Is there a game like another world for me?
No, not at that point, actually. I was more interested in the craftsmanship itself.But to be honest, and it sounds like I'm just flattering here, but the game that has had the most impact on me is Eco, because it completely changed my perspective on what games can become. And I still have that very powerful memory of experiencing that game.
はい。あ、そうなんですか。それはそのものすごく光栄ですね。
I'm flattered.
Well, so Ueda-san, you said that you've never been satisfied with the game that you released, and it's too painful to play them for yourself. So do you think it's possible for you to be satisfied with the game?
そうですね。満足したいと思う気持ちで作ってはいますね。そういう期待で作り続けないと、モチベーションが続かないっていうのもあるんで、常に、高い満足度で作りたいなと思う気持ちで作ってます。ただ、残念ながらこれまで作ったタイトルというのは、満足してますかと言われると、という感じですね。
My mindset is like to make games all the time. I aim to create a game which I'm satisfied with.
One day.
Otherwise, there is no motivation for me to make. But unfortunately, I'm not. Yeah, if you ask, I'm totally satisfied with my three titles. No.
I know that many, many creators feel the same way, that there's a lot of frustration with the result.
そうですよね。
Okay, so in Sweden, we don't know much about Fumito Ueda as a private person. Are you this crazy millionaire? You live in a mansion, you have 10 Ferraris, or what do you like?
はい。いや、そんなことないです。本当に普通の、部屋に住んで、今回スウェーデンに来るってこともあって、ボルボ 買いました。まあ、というのは冗談です。半分冗談ですけど、本当にボルボが乗っていまして、それは今回来るから買ったわけではないですけど、もともとボルボという車が好きで乗ってますね。
So, no, not at all. I live in a normal house. And since I'm coming to Sweden this time, I just bought a Volvo. No, it's a joke. But I bought a Volvo, that's true. But because I like that car.
Brilliant.
But not related to this travel.
And do you travel a lot?
実はそれほどしないんですよ。僕が作ってる作品のイメージから、遺跡であったりとか、世界の美しい場所をいろいろこう見てるんだっていうふうに思われてるんですけど、すべてはこう頭の中のイマジネーションで作っているので、言われてるほどは行ってないです。こういうふうな仕事の出張で海外に行くぐらいで、プライベートで行ったってのは本当に数えられる程度ですね。
Not so much. So people think I travel a lot and visiting those beautiful sceneries I create or visiting ruins, that kind of environment. But actually it all comes from my head, my imagination. So that's not the comes from my travel. I travel sometimes with business like this time, but very seldom I travel private.
And looking at Trico, that is so alive, do you have pets?
ペットはですね、実家で幼い頃に、僕が幼い頃に、実家でたくさん動物がいる家庭だったんですね。で、日本でも珍しいんですけど、例えば、犬や猫っていうのは当然いたり、あと、珍しいところで言うとアヒルだったり、あとちっちゃなお猿さん、リスザルって猿だったり、あとは自分が取ってきた昆虫だったり、蛇だったりみたいなものを結構自由に飼わせてくれる家庭だったので、その時にいろんな動物と触れ合って、その時の記憶がきっとトリコを作る上でも役に立っているので、僕個人はあんまりそういう YouTube とかの資料を見たって記憶はなくて、当然アニメーターのスタッフはいろんな資料を見て研究して作ってるとは思うんですけど、僕が何かを指示を出すときっていうのは、その幼い頃に飼ってた動物との触れ合いの記憶で、そこからこう、もっとこうしましょうとか、こんな動きは不自然だよってことを、指摘をしてましたね。
When I was a kid, my parents had a lot of animals. That are house with a dog, a cat, and even a duck or a monkey, small tiny monkey also. And my parents also allowed me to pick up the insects or a snake. So they let them, let me to play with a lot of animals. So that is my childhood.And when creating those animals in the games, like Trico you mentioned, my staff, like animators, I know that they are referencing a lot of YouTube videos and such. But myself, I don't need to check. I can say that which is not a very natural movement or such from my own memories from my childhood.
As an animal lover, I had that feeling when I was meeting Trico, that it's moving and behaving, and the shyness is extremely accurate for a real animal.
そうですね。動物飼われているんですよね。
Do you have any animal?
Yes,、yes, I have too many.
そういう
dogs and cats, and I'm trying to get a squirrel to move into my garden as well.
そうなんだ。
But it's very hard to convince the squirrel to do that.
そうかそうか、飼ってるってわけじゃないですね。
Okay, so let's wrap this up. I have just two questions about the future. And we already agreed that it's, just so you know, it's pointless to talk about what you're going to do next, and the same for us, because we can't answer that. So even though it's a question that many people asked, we will not dive into that. So two questions. The first one is, in general, what do you think games can become? Because it's a new medium, and we don't understand it so well yet. So what do you think about the opportunity of games?
はい、まあ、この質問もいろんなところで聞かれるんですけど、僕自身はあまりゲーム業界全体のことを意識して作ってなくて、あくまでその他の映画や音楽や小説や、あまたあるその娯楽の中の一つとしてビデオゲームが、存在するんじゃないかなというふうに考えています。なので、ビデオゲームだから、特別こういうことをしないといけないっていうふうには考えてなくて、まあお客さんがこうワクワクして手に取って、そのちゃんとその対価を払って買ってくれるようなものを作れればいいなというふうには個人的には考えてますね。
Yeah, I got this question a lot, but my personal answer is that game is one of the entertainment. There are novels and movies, and among those entertainments, so game is there. So that it'll be for game, it'll be enough that the people pay for the game and they got the money. So that's nothing more than that.
Okay.
But it's very my personal.
特殊なことじゃなくて。
It's not very special.
No, in a way.
どう考えてますか?
What's your opinion or your view?
Well, I believe that we are where the movie industry was in the beginning. I believe that it's still a very primitive use of a medium that has much broader possibilities. And I think specifically when it comes to narrative and AI,it's quite underexplored in most games. But we will see. So my final question, Ueda-san, if you met today a young Fumito Ueda and he asked you for advice about his future, what advice would you give him?
ですね、今こうやって僕はゲームを作って、3作作って、日本人の中では非常に珍しくこう世界の人たちに名前を知ってもらえてるっていうのは多分そのゲームをスタートした時、キャリアをスタートした時っていうのはもう全く想像してなかったことなんですよね。なのでそうですね。そういう風になるよっていう風に伝えるかどうかは迷うところですけど、そうですね。いろんな表現があると思いますけど、やっぱりゲームを進めると思いますね。ビデオゲームの開発を進めると思います。合ってますかね。
I released three titles now.And it was quite well accepted all over the world. So, got my name on it, but that was I never imagined I'll be like myself now at that time. But it's very difficult. But I think that I recommend that young myself. Just go with game developing.
Sorry, just
go with game developing.
Okay, so you did the right thing.Perfect. Okay, thank you very much. That concludes our hour, and it was a huge pleasure to meet you. Thank you so much for today.